Once the adrenaline had worn off, the uncomfortable train seat and glaring sunlight were the only things stopping me from falling asleep. My implants had been injecting me with a substance keeping me alert and focused all night, and now I came crashing down hard. The confrontation at Joris Plaza had been hairier than expected, but catching the sniper and his associate was a huge win. I wondered if this was the beginning of the end of the case, or just its beginning. I finally got up at my stop and left the train, only to suddenly wake up in my seat again and realize it had been a dream. I decided to stand next to the door for the rest of the ride. A cool breeze cut into the train cart and through the haze of fatigue when the doors opened. I considered visiting Kat, suddenly feeling an urge to inhale the woody, slightly dusty air in our old apartment. Kat had filled it with what she affectionately called real things. She loved leather, cloth, paper, and plants, and hated the clean metallic surfaces at my apartment. Sometimes I did too. got into the elevator and leaned against a wall. I was so tired in that moment that my reflex of emotional repression whenever I saw Kat didn't seem to work anymore. It hit me with an unusual clarity that, even a decade after it had ended, I hadn't ever fully let go of her. I wasn't sure what to make of it, whether to be happy or to finally push myself to it. I concluded that I would probably just go back to repressing it altogether. Waking up in the early evening was disorienting. I sat up on my bed and allowed the memories from the previous night to pour back in. Banny's body, the hotel, Lila, the shootout. I tried to put it all in an order that made sense and got on my way back to work. A hint of the good mood that had overcome me outside of the villa returned. Once again, it stemmed from what had made me join the CDI many years ago. The feeling of doing something instead of taking a back seat and waiting for death. There was a time when a lack of purpose threatened to consume me, lurking underneath meaningless daily routines and self-doubt sabotaging everything I did. Walking among the people outside, I felt even more alienated than usual. It was like they lived in another reality. Many were just getting out of work, looking to do some shopping, meet a friend, have a drink. Maybe I would find my way back to that reality one day. I wanted to, yet at the same time, hated the thought of it.
Thank you. Thank you.
During the train ride, every screen in the city had been playing news reports about the Liberators' announcement. They were the first violent domestic terror group with a political motive in recent Garian history. But there was something else that struck me about them. This wasn't the usual MO of a conservative group trying to maintain the status quo. It felt much more like revolutionaries hoping to effect change by resorting to drastic measures.